Hello everyone, welcome back to Chinda DIY. And today's video, I'll be showing you how to crochet a granny dress. For this dress, I make for size small. And for this dress, it is really easy to make. And in this video, I also showing you step by step how to make it bigger and how to measuring on your body, so you don't have to worry if you wear different size. Okay, now let's get into the video. And one more thing, for this dress, you can use any type or any size of yarn that's soft and lightweight. And if you guys don't have the same hook like mine, you can use any size of hook that fit with your yarn size. First thing first, we are going to make the cups and the underbust part. For the cups and the underbust part, please check the granny bralette tutorial that I put the link down below at the description. So you guys just follow the tutorial from 0.52 second until 32:52, and then you can come back to this video and continue to make the hip part and the bottom part of the dress. And for my underbust part, I made 20 rolls. It is equal 6.5 inches. It's measuring from my underbust until my navel. For you guys that make bigger size, please add more rolls until it reach your navel. And this is what the back part looks like. Next, we are going to make the waist part. As you can see in this picture, turn your top and attach the yarn into the corner of the stitch. Make sure that you're working on the wrong side of the stitch. And then make 20 chains. If you guys that make bigger size, please add more chains until it fit around your waist. So if you see this foundation chain is long, just don't confusing because I made it too big. If you guys make the dress size more like mine, just follow the description that I show on the screen. After you got your desired length, then continue make slip stitch into the other size corner. Make sure that your foundation chain doesn't twist. After you have made slip stitch, and this is what it looks like. And this is what the top looks like after you have connect the foundation chains together. So for the measurement around this bottom part, it is equal 25 inches. It's the measurement around my waist. Like I said, if you guys want it bigger, please add more chains until it fit around your waist. Continue from where your last stitch is for row 1, chain 2, and make double crochet into the double crochet space that near chain 2. After you have made a double crochet, and then continue make granny stitch around until you reach the stitch near the chains, then I will meet you back again. After you have made granny stitch near the foundation chains, then skip one chain and make double crochet into every chain until you have one last chain. Then I will meet you back again. Thank you. After you had one last chain, then we are going to skip that last chain and make double crochet into the double crochet space that need chain 2. After you have made a double crochet, and then make slip stitch into the chain 2 stitch. After you have made slip stitch, then cut off the yarn. And next, place your top like this, and we are going to use stitch marker to mark at this both side of the waist part. So the stitch that we mark, it is where we are going to make increase for the hip part. Continue from where your last stitch is, and we are going to change the color and attach the yarn. Next, for row 2, chain 2, turn your work. And we are going to make double crochet into the stitch near chain 2. After you have made a double crochet, then skip 2 stitches and make 3 double crochet into the 3rd stitch. We are making granny stitch. So keep repeating this by skip 2 stitches and make 3 double crochet into the next stitch until you reach the stitch marker, then I will meet you back again. After you reach the stitch near stitch marker, then remove the stitch marker and we are going to make increase by make 6 double crochet into this big space. After you got 6 double crochet into the same stitch, then continue make granny stitch until you reach the 2nd stitch marker, and I will meet you back again. After you reach the 2nd stitch marker, then remove the stitch marker and we are going to make increase by make 6 double crochet into this big space. After you got 6 double crochet in the same stitch, then continue make granny stitch until you reach the end of the row, and I will meet you back again. After you reach the end of the row, we are going to skip this double crochet stitch and continue make slip stitch into the chain 2 stitch. After you have made slip stitch, then cut off the yarn and change the color. For row 3, attach the yarn, chain 2, and turn your work. Then make two double crochet into the space that need chain 2. After you have made 2 double crochet, then continue make granny stitch until you reach the increasing stitch and I will meet you back again. After you reach the stitch near increasing stitch, then we are going to skip 3 stitches and make 3 double crochet into this double crochet space. After you have made 3 double crochet in the same stitch, then continue make granny stitch until you reach the second increasing stitch and I will meet you back again. After you reach the second increasing stitch, then skip 3 stitches and make 3 double crochet into this double crochet space. After you got 3 double crochet in the same stitch, then continue make granny stitch until you reach the end of the row and I will meet you back again. After you reach the end of the row, then we are going to skip this double crochet stitch and continue make slip stitch into the chain 2 stitch. After you have made slip stitch, then cut off the yarn and we are going to change the color. For row 4, attach the yarn, chain 2, and turn your work. Then make 2 double crochet into the double crochet space that need chain 2. After you have made 2 double crochet, then continue make granny stitch until you reach the increasing part and I will meet you back again. After you reach the stitch near the increasing part, as you can see we have the back space and the front space between the increasing part, so you can make increase into the front or into the back space. Next, we are going to make increase by make 6 double crochet into the same stitch. After you got 6 double crochet in the same stitch, then continue make granny stitch until you reach the other increasing part and I will meet you back again. So for the second increasing part, I may increase into the front space. After you got 6 double crochet in the same stitch, then continue make granny stitch until you reach the end of the row, and then make slip stitch into the chain 2 stitch. After you have made slip stitch, then cut off the yarn and change the color. For the next row, please keep repeating row 3 and row 4 until you reach row 15. It means that you are going to make one row with increase and one row without increase. For you guys that make bigger size, please keep increasing by repeat row 3 and row 4 until you reach your hip measurement, then I will meet you back again. And this is what my hip part looks like after I reach row 15. So for the measuring around this row 15, it is equal 33 inches. It's the measurement around my hip. Like I said, if you guys want it bigger, please keep increasing by repeat row 3 and row 4. And this is what my back part looks like. And this is my waist part and my hip part. So after you reach your hip measurement, just stop increase. Next, start from row 16 until row 33. Just make granny stitch around, no increase. And for the measurement from row 16 until row 33, it is equal 6.5 inches. And this is what the bottom part looks like after you reach row 33. You can try this on your body and use stitch marker to mark at the place that you want to make the slit. And next, we are going to make the slit part. Turn your dress. As you can see, this is the right side of the stitch. So turn your work. We are going to working on the wrong side of the stitch. To begin, attach the yarn into the stitch that you mark. Next, for row 1, chain 2 and make double crochet into the same space with chain 2. After you have made a double crochet, then continue make granny stitch around until you reach the end of the row, then I will meet you back again. After you reach the end of the row, we are going to skip these 3 stitches and make a double crochet into the same space with chain 2. After you have made a double crochet, and then cut off the yarn and change the color. Next, for row 2, attach the yarn, chain 2, and turn your work. Then make 2 double crochet into the double crochet space that need chain 2. After you have made 2 double crochet, then continue make granny stitch around until you reach the end of the row, then I will meet you back again. After you reach the end of the row, then skip this double crochet stitch, and we are going to make double crochet into this chain 2 stitch. After you have made double crochet, then cut off the yarn and change the color. For row 3, attach the yarn, chain 2, turn your work, and make double crochet into the double crochet space that you chain 2. After you have made a double crochet, then continue make granny stitch around until you reach the end of the row, and I will meet you back again. After you reach the end of the row, then skip these 2 stitches and make a double crochet into this chain 2 stitch. And this is what it looks like. Next, cut off the yarn and change the color. For the next row, please keep repeating row 2 and row 3 until you reach row 12. It is equal 4 inches. If you guys want your dress longer, please add more rows. And this is what my dress looks like. After you got your desired fit, next, we are going to make single crochet as the border around this bottom edge. To begin, attach the yarn into the corner stitch and chain 1. Then continue make single crochet into every stitch around until you have 1 last stitch, and I will meet you back again. After you had 1 last stitch, then we are going to make slip stitch into that last stitch. Then chain 1 and cut off the yarn. For the remaining yarn, please use darning needle to weave in. And this is what the slit part looks like. Next, we are going to make the strap. We are going to attach the yarn into these 3 stitches with different colors. Next, please chain long enough for your strap. And after you got 3 strands of foundation chain, then we are going to braid them together like the regular braid. after you reach to the end, then make a knot. And for this remaining yarn, tie them together and use darning needle to weave in. Please don't forget to repeat the same thing to the other side. And this is what my strap looks like. Turn your top. And next, we are going to make single crochet as the border around this back edge. To begin, attach the yarn into the corner part. And chain one, and then continue make single crochet into every stitch until you reach the corner near the waist part, and I will meet you back again. After you reach the corner part, then continue make single crochet into each double crochet space until you reach the other corner, then I will meet you back again. After you reach the corner, then continue make single crochet into every stitch until you reach the end of the row, and I will meet you back again. After you reach the end of the row, and this is what it looks like. For the next part, we are going to make the corset holes. Follow 2, chain 1. Turn your work. And then make 2 more chains. Then skip 2 stitches and make single crochet into the next 5 stitches. After you got 5 stitches of single crochet, then chain 2. Skip 2 stitches and make single crochet into the next 5 stitches. Keep repeating this by chain 2, skip 2 stitches and make single crochet into the next 5 stitches until you reach the corner which is near the waist part. Then I will meet you back again. Make sure that you have the corset hole at this waist part too. Next, continue make single crochet into this waist part until you reach the other corner and I will meet you back again. After you reach the corner, then we are going to make corset holes by repeat the same thing like the other side. Continue make 2 chains. Skip 2 stitches and make single crochet into the next 5 stitches. Keep repeating this until you reach the end of the row and I will meet you back again. After you reach the end of the row, then chain 1 and cut off the yarn. For the remaining yarn, please use the needle to weave in. And this is what my back part looks like. For the back lace, just make the foundation chains long enough. If you guys don't want to separate like this, just make the braiding strap really long so you can weave in the strap into this back corset holes. After you have weaved in the lace into each hole, then we are going to continue weaving the lace into this double crochet row, which is the waist part, and insert the hook into the next 2 stitches. Then pull the yarn through these both stitches. Skip 2 stitches and insert the hook into the next 2 stitches. Then pull the yarn through these both stitches. Keep repeating this until you reach the middle part. After you reach the middle part, And then we are going to repeat the same thing to the other side. And this is what it looks like. And now your granny dress is done. If you like this tutorial, please don't forget to click like and leave a positive comment down below. Stay safe and stay healthy, and I'll see you guys in the next video. Bye bye.